Hi, in this tutorial I'm going to take you through how to mark an Excel list as a table. But before we get into that, first let's understand what is this needing to make something into a table. Isn't everything a table in itself? Let's try to understand that first. Now on the screen what you see is the database of some students, their roll number, their name and marks. Now to you and me this looks like a table, but as far as Excel is concerned, all that it knows is in cell B2, there is a text called roll number, and in cell B4, there is a text called T001. And in C4 has a text called ARJUN SANGH. Excel doesn't know the relationship between them. For it, all it knows is these are cells and these cells have some contents in it. But you and I know the relationship. We know that the roll number pertains to student Arjun Singh and this mark also pertains to the student Arjun Singh. How do you make this relationship obvious in Excel? Here, that can be done by making it into a table. In versions prior to 2007, this was referred as list, but 2007 onwards, this is now called as a table. I call it as list table, just to distinguish it from pivot tables and data tables. So how do we make this into a list table? So what you do is select the region that you want to mark as a list or a list table. Then go to the Insert tab. In Insert tab, you have this table option. Click on that. Once you click on that, you would notice that a dialog box appears asking you to specify the table range. And it is also asking us whether the table has headers. Our table has headings, roll numbers, student, marks. So that's the heading. If the heading exists, tick the box and click OK. Once you have done that, now this has become a table. What's the advantage of working with table? Well, that is something we'll learn a little later. But once you have a table, the way the table works is slightly different from the way it works with regular cell. Of course, you can use all regular Excel operation with a table as well. But there are some differences. To point out, one thing that happens is, let's say I'm going to give a summation of all the marks or I want to get average score of the students. I'm going to type average and I select this column. Now you notice that when I selected this, it doesn't say D4 to D13. It is average table 1 marks. Marks is the field and table 1 is the name of the table. So it says you want to take the field marks from table 1. Of course, I could have as well given the regular Excel reference as well. I could have done equals to average cell D4 to D13, that would have worked as well. But when you select this table, it is going to come as table 1 marks. What's the advantage of this? There are many advantages. One basic advantage, let me explain to you right away. When it's a table, what you would notice is as I keep adding more and more records. So every row here is a record. Every column is a field. As I keep adding more records, let's say I have another student called as Stephanie Lopez, some name I'm just giving it, and her score was 68. And I had one more student, T011, which is Thyagarajan Ramkumar, whose score was 71. What you notice is, look at the averages we took. Firstly, the table automatically expanded when we type the name. In case if you missed it, let me just add it once more. T012 Urvashi Nair. Right? Notice what happened. When I type 2012, the table expanded. How do I know this table has expanded? Notice this bottom right corner of a table. You see a small mirror image of an L, that reverse L mark. That indicates the end of a table and this keeps expanding. And what happened as we added more students, our rows table is expanding and our formula is also automatically expanding. So when you have a list, it makes it easy for us to then operate on this list elsewhere, because as the list expands, our formula elsewhere will also automatically keep expanding. Now this table has a name, table 1, which looks very generic. If you're Excel file has a lot of tables, then you may not want to refer them by table 1 and 2. In that case, what you can do, You can give these tables customized name. How do you give them? Select the table, put your cursor on the table. Then you have the table design contextual menu opening up. Go to that. And on the left side, you will see the table name box. Right now it reads table one. I probably want to call it mark list. I'll call it as mark list. That's it. So now if you look at our formulas, it calls it as mark list marks. So this table has a name that we can easily recollect. There are a few care you have to take when you're working with tables though. One is, or most important is copy pasting. Notice one thing, that when I've created a formula which is average of D4 to D16, when I copy and paste it to the neighboring column, the D4 to D6 now becomes average of E4 to E16. The column reference changes, which I'm hoping all of you already know. But when I copy and paste a table, that doesn't happen. It's still average mark list marks. So when you copy and paste a table, or when you refer to a table, the range becomes an absolute reference. And therefore, when you copy and paste, it's going to be an absolute reference everywhere. So there's no concept of putting dollar or not putting a dollar here. Right? And when you're using table, if you want to copy paste it and you want it to be absolute reference, copy and paste, Control C, Control V. Dragging is not a great idea. Because when I drag here, what happens, you notice? From third column, our reference now goes to the first column. It'll, when you drag it, the reference will keep changing, not to necessarily to the right column, because if right column doesn't exist, it goes back to the first column. It goes on a circular path. So that, those are a few things that you got to take care of when it comes to table. So that's just an introduction to table. And we'll stop here.